show me the things that are just out of sight from my eyes. You whisper the words that will make things so right, so softly. Passed all my life so happy. Good evening. Another episode of my life coding. Today, going to implement a code workflow in your build pipeline using Git and GitHub, part of the Build Cloud Skill Challenge. And let's start the show. Welcome back. It's May 28th, 9 o'clock in the Netherlands, where I live. Today, I'm going to do another challenge for the build... What's his name? Build Cloud Skill Challenge. If you hit Bank Project in the chat room, then you see the link there that's... What I'm going to do, click on it. This is the one that we are going to do today. The cloud challenge consists of 28 modules. You don't have to do them all, but there are 5 sections: Azure DevOps languages and frameworks, extended Microsoft Teams, Power Platform, and Azure Serverless. And I'm trying to do them all. All 28 before June the 2nd. That's actually, I think, before Monday. And that's a real challenge because I'm only halfway, 50%. And the reason for this, that's that I yesterday did the Power Platform and this was really terribly documented. Lots of issues in the code and took me a lot of time to get the last one fixed. If you go to the Power Platform, the extend plugins, the last one is certainly not a recommendation to do, but today we're picking up the second one from the Azure DevOps challenge. We previously created a build pipeline with Azure Pipelines. Today, implement a code workflow in your build pipeline with using Git or GitHub, and GitHub, I should say. So that's, I think, module 1 hour and a half, 1 hour 27 minutes. So let's start with this. Introduction. You create build pipelines with Azure. You created a basic but complete build configuration with for ASP.NET Core web application. In this module, you extend this build configuration by implementing a code collaboration strategy that uses Git and GitHub. Elite performance, deploy code more frequently and experience much faster lead times than other performers. To become elite performers, developers need a way to work with source code and share the changes with others. Collaboration is a key DevOps value and a source control system that fosters cooperation. It's a great DevOps tool. Although Azure DevOps works with various kinds of source control, many developers choose Git because it's a distributed system that enables all contributors to have their own copy of the work. In this module, you use Git branching and merging capabilities to more efficiently work with other developers. You also use GitHub because it provides the central location for teams to host their project and share their work. Learning objectives. Collaborate with others by choosing, let me make it a little bit bigger for you to read. collaborate with others by choosing an appropriate branching and merging strategy. Add a batch to your GitHub repository to show the status of your latest build. That's nice and interesting. Add a dashboard widget to visualize your build history and set up a rule for GitHub repository to require a reviewer. Prereqs, you have Azure DevOps in your organization, yes. GitHub, yes. Visual Studio Code, yes. .NET Core 3.1 and Git. I think I have them all together. You can get started with Microsoft Azure DevOps for free. The environment lets you completely exercise this in this future, this and future modules. You can also use it to help apply your new skills to your own project. Meet the team. You met the space team, space game web team at Tailspin Toys in the previous module. As a refresher, here's how who you'll work with in this module. Andy is a developer lead, development lead. Amita is Q&A, and Mara just joined as developer and reports to Andy. Mara has prior experience with DevOps and is helping the team adopt more streamlined process that uses Azure DevOps. Choose a code flow strategy. It's important to choose a code flow strategy that fits you in with how you how your team works. There are several strategies to consider, and you find links that explain them at the end of the module. The Tailspin web team uses a code flow strategy that based on Git and GitHub. When Mara sets up Azure boards, she and her team identified a few initial tasks to address. One task is to create a Git-based workflow. Stabilize the build server, create a Git-based workflow, and I think this one is we did in the previous step. Let's listen in on the team on how as they work out a better way to collaborate. Currently, they are using a centralized version control system, but the plan is to move it to Git, a distributed system. Mara is diligently working on her assigned features when Andy walks in. Hi Mara, in the leadership meeting this morning, it was brought up that our team and the game development teams are using different version control systems. In effort to streamline how we share resources between teams, we have been asked to move the distributed version control system that can better handle the collaboration. That's good to know. If you remember, we put it on our board. Currently, we are using a centralized version control system. This works great for now, but I agree that when we start share between teams and our team gets bigger, a distributed version control system is a better choice. It's also a task on our board to increase visibility so all stakeholders know what everyone is doing. I think the distributed source control system like Git would help there as well. I've been wanting to try Git for a while. I've never just seemed to have the time. Is it difficult to learn or to set up? If it seems reasonable, maybe we could work on it now. I'm tired of always putting things off, it would be nice to be able to see what everyone is doing and to have access to the entire repository. Okay, what's it all about? Let me explain it, and then you can decide if it sounds like something we want to implement right away. Mara and Andy move to the whiteboard for a discussion on version control. What is Git and distributed version control? Centralized or distributed? Mara says the drawing on the left is centralized version control, like what we are using now. We have a central version of the code base in Team Foundation Control, Team Foundation Version Control, TFVC, that everyone uses. We each work on the files we need to change and then merge them back into the master repository when we are finished with them. Yes, and that's working for us well, except when I was blocked the time that a breaking change got merged into the central repo. Right, you were blocked. We could use branching strategy with TFVC to solve the blocking issue, but in our current configuration, merging might get a bit more complicated. And when we had that breaking change, number 3, there, no one could get any work done until we got that resolved. That problem is always lurking because we are all using the same copy of the code. On the right is a drawing. Of distributed version control, we still have a main or master repository that's a stable version of the code base, but each developer has their own copy of its work of it to work from. It frees up to experiment and try variety of approaches without affecting the main repository. Distributed version control also ensures that only working code get merged into the master repository. We would even set it up to where code can't be merged until it's been reviewed. What's cool about Azure DevOps is that it works well with both centralized and distributed version control systems. What happens when when more than one person changes the same file? Often Git can merge multiple changes automatically. Of course, we want to always make sure the combination of changes results in working code. When Git can't automatically merge changes, it marks the conflict directly in the file so that the human can choose which changes to accept. Right now, our code is stored in our own server. Where will it be when we move to distributed version control? I'm glad you asked. That's where hosting comes in. Where can I host my repository? When we decided where to host the repositories, we have a few options. For example, you can host them on a local server in Bitbucket or in GitHub. Bitbucket and GitHub are web-based hosting solutions. We can access them from anywhere. Have you used either of them? I've used GitHub in the past. It has features that are important for developers, like easy access to change logs and version control features from either the command line or the online portal. So how does Git work? How do I work with Git? Like I mentioned before, with distributed system, developers are free to access any file that need without affecting other developers' work, because they need to have their own copy of the repository. A clone is your local copy of the repository. When we work on a feature or a bug fix, we usually want to try different approaches until we find the best solution. But trying out code on your copy of the main code base isn't a good idea, because you may not want to keep the first few tries. To give you a better option, Git has a feature called branching, where you can maintain as many copies as you want and merge back only the one you want to keep. This keeps the main branch stable. I get the concept so far. How do I check in my code? How do my local changes get up in the main code base? In Git, the main branch or trunk is typically called the master. After you feel the code is ready to be merged in the master, in the main repository that's shared by all developers, you create what's called a pull request. So when you create a pull request, you're telling the other developers that your code are ready to review and you want to merge it into the master branch. When your pull request is approved, it becomes part of the master code base. What does the branching workflow look like? Step 1, when you begin to work in a new feature or bug fix, the first thing you want to do is make sure you're starting with the latest stable code base. To do this, you can synchronize your copy of the master branch with the server copy. This pulls down all the developer changes that have been pushed up to the master branch on the server since last synchronization. So you pull it into local. To make sure you're working safely on this copy of the code, you create a new branch just for the feature of a bug fix. As you can imagine, have many branches for all the things that you might get hard. You're doing might get hard to remember, so a good naming convention is critical here. Before you make changes to the file, you check out the new branch so that you know that you're working on the files on that branch and not a different branch. You can switch between branches any time by checking out that branch. You're now safe to make whatever changes you want because these changes are only in your branch. As you work, you can commit your changes to the branch to make sure that you don't lose any work and to provide a way to roll back any changes you've made to previous versions. Before you can commit changes, you need to stage your files so the Git knows which one are ready to commit. So you work on the branch and that eventually will flow back to the master. The next step is to push or upload your local branch up to the remote repository such as GitHub so that others can see what you're working on. Don't worry, this won't merge your changes yet. You can push up your work as often as you'd like. In fact, it's a good way to back up your work and enable yourself to work from multiple computers. Step 5. This step is a common one, but not required. When you're satisfied with your code, your code is working as you want it to, you can pull or merge the remote master branch back into the local master branch. Changes have been taking place there that your local master branch doesn't have yet. After you've synchronized the remote branch with yours, merge your local master branch into the working branch and test your build again. This process helps you ensure that your feature works with the latest code. It also helps ensure that your work will integrate smoothly when you submit your pull request. Step 6, your local code now needs to be committed and pushed into the hosted repository. This is the same as step 3 and 4. Step 7, you're finally ready to propose your changes to the remote master branch. To do this, you begin a pull request. This triggers a continuous integration build process, such as your pipelines, and you can watch your changes move through the pipeline. After the build succeeds and others approve your pull request, your code is merged into the remote branch. This all looks complicated and hard to learn. And Mara says, Git can seem intimidating because it's so powerful. But after you get the hang of the flow, it starts to feel natural. You'll use only a few commands daily. Here's a summary. Create a Git repository, Git init, download the repository, Git clone, Git checkout, Git status, Git add, Git commit, Git pull, Git push. That sounds like a great starting point. I can definitely handle that. I can learn more advanced commands as I need them. Which type of version control enables you to work from your own copy of the main repository? Centralized or Team Foundation version control or distributed? I'd say distributed. Git branch is used to copy only the part of the repository you want to work on. No. Make changes and experiment with the code base without affecting other developers' work. Yes. Create an entire new repository that's not connected to the main repository. No, that's like a fork, I think. Git pull command uploads changes from your local repository to the remote repository. No, that's a push. Downloads and merges latest changes from the remote repository into your local repository. I think that's the case. Plunk. Ready to go. Ta-ra-la-la-lum. Continue. Set up your Azure DevOps. In this unit, you ensure that your Azure DevOps organization is set up to completely complete the rest of the module. To do this, set up Azure DevOps. I think I've been doing this in the previous one. So let's see if we can use the previous one or need to do it all over again. Here you get the Azure DevOps project. Here you make sure that your DevOps organization is set up to complete the rest of the module. You do this by running a template that creates a project for you in Azure DevOps. The modules in this learning path form a progression where you follow the tailspins and blah, blah, blah. For learning purpose, each module has an associated Azure DevOps project. Run the template. Let's check. Sign in. Question is, who is this? Sign out. Run the template, sign in. This one. Now it must be me. Let's see. Sign in, create a new project, select your Azure DevOps organization, this one, enter project name, select fork repository on GitHub, create a new project, select your, and then enter your project name, select fork repository on GitHub. Yes, I want to fork this repository. Authorize. Azure DevOps demo generator, I give them access. Yeah, I need to put my GitHub password in. Select fork repository. Yes, you need to select the option to for the template to connect to your GitHub repository, select it even if you already forked the Space Game website project. Template uses your existing fork. Okay. Create project. Select create project. Something's happening. Select navigate to project. One team's created. Navigate to project. There you go. Important, to clean up Azure DevOps environment. The pages and module contains blah, blah, blah. Set up your project visibility. That's also important if you want to have it private. That's the same as in the previous module. Move the work item to doing. In this section, you assign yourself a work item that relates to this module. On the Azure board, you also move the work item into the doing state. In practice, you and your team would assign work items at the start of each sprint or work iteration. Let's make this a little bit bigger. Assigning work in this way gives you a checklist to work from. It gives you others on your team visibility into what you're working on and how much work is left. It also helps the team enforce work in process, so that the team doesn't take on too much work on at one time. Recall that the team settled on these 7 topics. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here you move the second item, Git-based workflow, to doing. Let's see if it's actually in the system. Boards, sprints. Let's see. Recall the create Git-based workflow relates something, blah, blah, blah. First need to find it. Boards. There's the board. This one was the previous one. Interesting that they are now numbered. Let's see. Here you move the second item. Create a Git-based workflow to doing. Create a Git-based workflow to doing. There you are. And assign yourself to the work item. Right here. Nice. Recall that create Git-based workflow relates to moving the code for a workflow that enables better collaboration among team and members. To set the work item, go to, this is what we already did, boards, create Git-based, select to do, drag it over. This one is the previous one. At the end of the module, you have completed the task. You'll move the card to the done column, like this one. Set the project up locally. Here you load the Space Game project in Visual Studio Code. Configure Git, clone the repository locally, and set the upstream to remote. If you already set it up with the MS Learn Tailspin Game Web project locally, you can move to the next section. I'm not sure if it's on the same machine. Let's check that out. Not sure. Don't think so. Start Visual Studio Code on the View menu. Select Terminal, Integrated Terminal. Oh, Visual Studio Code. So maybe it is on this machine already. Projects. Build school. No, I don't think so. Maybe on the repos. No. Start Visual Studio. Code, Visual Studio Code. Different one. We put it side by side a little bit. Terminal window lets you choose anything like this. Where I'm using the command window. If you need to get a GitHub, you first need to install a new command. Well, it's already done. Set up your project in Visual Studio Code. Go to your fork on GitHub. Repositories, I think it's this one. When was it created? 3 days ago? Updated 3 days ago? Okay. Copy this. Copy git, oh, git clone. What's happening there? This is my display. Git clone. Like this. Git clone. There. The MS Learn. Git remote dash V. See two of these versions. Git remote add upstream. Git remote V. Now you have the upstream. Let's see, on the file, in Visual Studio Code, file menu, open folder, while I do this like this, code, dot, much easier. Navigate to the root directory. Okay, to the root directory of the space game web project, you can run pwd command in terminal window to see the full path, if you need to remember. It's already here. You're now ready to set up with the Space Game source code. Continue. Create a pull request. In this unit, let's make the text a little bit smaller. Practice the process of submitting a pull request and merging your changes in the master branch so that everyone can benefit from your work. Create a build pipeline. You created a Git branch build pipeline. That's what we already did. Where to define the basic pipeline goes into Azure YAML pipeline. It's this one. Although your branch produces a build artifact, that work exists only on the build pipeline branch. Recall that pull request tells the other developers that you have code ready to review if necessary and you want to change and merge into another branch such as master. Before we start, by the way, we are, I don't know where we are. Hi Mara, I know you've got the build pipeline running in Azure. I'm adding a feature to the website and I want to see the build process for myself. Are we ready to do that? Absolutely. I created a pipeline on that on a branch. Why don't we set up a pull request and get it merged into the master so you can use the pipeline too? Sounds great. Let's take a look. Create a branch and add starter code. Although you use the build pipeline you built in the previous module, you'll create a new branch named Code Workflow. That's based off of master so that you can practice the process from the beginning. If you completed the previous module, your branch includes a basic but complete build configuration in your Azure pipelines.yaml. If you haven't completed the previous module, it will create a file. In Visstudio, open integrated terminal. Control tick. There you go. Make this full screen. Ooh. Make this full screen. Git checkout master. Git. Oh, darn it. Type me in the file. Git. Git checkout master. Already on master. Ensure you have the latest version of code. Git pull origin master. Git pull origin master. Already up to date. Create a branch named work code workflow. Git checkout b code workflow. Git checkout dash b code dash workflow. Let's check. Yeah, switch to new branch from the file explorer. Open Azure pipelines.yaml and replace the content. With this copy, Ubuntu latest. Yeah. That configuration resembles the basic one that you created previously. For brevity, it builds only your project's release configuration. Okay, so no longer the build, the debug version. interesting. Push your branch to GitHub. Git status. One file changed. Git add Azure pipelines. Git commit M. Git commit SM some comment. Add the build configuration. Add the build configuration. M arguments for a message. Yes. Run the git push command to push. Git push. Well, we first need to go and check if it's actually enabled. DevOps. Yeah, space. Oh, we have a new one. This was one of the previous one. Smaller. Where's the instructions? Here. You have to pull this aside. There you go. I think we still need to do this one. Where's my code window? Here. Git status. We did the commit the last time that we looked. This one. Run the git push command. Git push origin code workflow. Wants to sign in, allow, continue, open, open, let's try again. Everything's up to date, but let's check. Copy the code, switch back to Visual Studio Code. Maybe you were wrong for the first time. Maybe I was looking for. Click signing into null in the status bar. Changes. I think it was already logged in. Okay. Well, let's see what happens. Where's my air? Oops. Optional, go to the project as your pipelines, trace the build as it runs. Where is my project? Here, pipelines. Already did it, I think. Stages. One published. And we have a release drop. Okay. There's an option step. This build is called CI. Was called CI build. Can we see that? No. Pipelines. Your pipeline configuration uses what is called a trigger to control which branches participate in the process. Here, star specifies all branches. Trigger star. That's probably. Where's the trigger? Here. Okay. Create a pull request. Later you'll see the control of the pipeline configuration to build from only the branches that you need. You see the build complete successfully and produce an artifact that contains the built web application. Create a pull request. Here you create a pull request for your branch. In your browser, sign into GitHub. That's what I already did here. Go back. There. Go to your repository in the branch drop down, select code workflow branch. Code workflow. How many branches are there? That's a lot. And then go to the workflow to start pull request, select new pull request. Two commits ahead of master. New pull request. Ensure the base specifies your fork repository and not Microsoft repository. Ensure the base specifies your fork repository. Oops. That will change to master, compare, code workflow. That changes, yes. Able to merge, yes. Important step is important because you can't merge changes into the Microsoft repository. Make sure that the base repository points to your repository and not Microsoft docs. When you work directly from with your own repository and not the fork, your master branch will be selected by default. Enter a title, configure as your pipelines, copy. Description, copy. This pipeline configures the build application configuration, builds the application and produces a build for the release configuration. To complete your pull request, select create pull request. There. This step does not merge any code. It tells others that you have changes that you are proposing to merge into master. Create pull request. Pull request, that's the button. The pull request window is displayed. You can see the build status there. As your pipeline is configured to appear as part of the pull request. That way, you and others can view the status of the build as it's running. Pending. That way, you and others can view the status of the build as it is running. Just like you, when you push the branch to GitHub, a pull request by default triggers Microsoft Azure pipelines to build your application. Optionally, select the details link. This one, I think. And trace the build as it moves through the pipeline. And you can hand off your build to the next step in the process, such as QA. Later, you can configure the pipeline through to push your changes all the way out to your Q&A lab. Go back to the pull request on GitHub. Wait for the build to complete. You're now ready to merge your pull request. Question, is it building or is it not building? Request is displayed, you can see that the build in Azure pipeline is configured as appears part of the pull request. That way the others can view status of the build as it's running. Details. Minutes ago. I think that's this one. Was published. So where did this instruction? Where's my... That is how I feel when the mirror shows me a stranger. Yeah. And I know they're just friends. This one, oh, it's already, yeah, it's now done. All checks have passed. The branch is no conflict. Where's the instruction? Here you go. Wait for the build to complete. It's done. Select merge pull request. Merge pull request. And confirm merge. To delete the code workflow branch from GitHub, select delete branch. Branch. It's completely safe to delete the branch from GitHub after you've merged your pull request. In fact, it's common practice because the branch is no longer needed. The changes are merged and you can still find the details about the changes on GitHub or from the command line. Deleting a merged branch also helps others to see only the work that's currently active. Git branches are meant to be short-lived. After you merge a branch, you don't push additional commits onto it or merge it a second time. In most cases, every time you start a new feature or a bug fix, you start with a clean branch that's based on the master branch. Deleting a branch on GitHub doesn't delete the branch from your local system. To do that, you would pass Deleting a branch on GitHub doesn't delete that branch from your local system. To do that, you would pass the D switch to the git branch command. How many times is change built? The answer depends on how your configuration is defined. Azure Pipelines enables you to define triggers that specify which events cause builds to happen. Where is it? As an example, you say that you want a build to happen when a change is pushed to GitHub on any Git branch, but you don't want the build to happen when only changes are to the files in your project docs folder. You might include trigger section in your build configuration. Copy. Make that in the trigger. Like such. By default, the build is triggered when a change is pushed to any file or branch. Continuous integration build is a build that runs when you push a change to a branch. A pull request is a build that runs when you open a pull request or when you push additional changes to an existing pull request. The changes you make through the code workflow branch are built under three conditions. A CI build happens when you push changes to code workflow. A pull request happens when you open a pull request. And a final continuous integration build happens when a pull request is merged into master. Pull request helps you to verify that your proposed changes will work correctly after they've merged to the master or another target branch. The final CI build verifies that the changes are still good after the PR was merged. An optional step to go to Azure Pipelines and watch the final CI happen on the master branch. Next, push change through the pipeline. This unit, you practice the complete workflow by pushing small changes to the Space Game website to GitHub. Marek has given the task of changing some text on the homepage of the website index.cshtml. In this unit, you will follow along. Let's briefly review the steps to follow the complete task. Synchronize your local repository, create a branch, make the code changes, push the branch, merge any recent changes from the master to the into your local working branch and verify that changes still work. Push up and remaining changes, watch Azure Pipelines build the application. Fetch the latest master branch. Git checkout master. Git checkout master. Come close to me. I'll whisper in your ear the things that we could be. Local changes to the following. Let's get status. Yeah, that's the reason because we changed this one. So let's undo it. Oops. Discard changes, discard changes. Yeah. Hit status. Hit checkout master. That's interesting. Git pull, oh yeah. Get the latest changes. Git pull origin master. Git, oh, darn it. Git pull origin master. Now it's back to the changes. You can view the list of files that were changed. It's an optional step. You can open Azure Pipelines YAML to verify its complete build configuration. Recall the Git repository where teams member collaborate. It's calling a remote. Here, Origin specifies your repository on GitHub. Later, you'll fetch starter code from Microsoft GitHub repository known as Upstream. It's built. .NET build configuration release. .NET build configuration release. Let's copy this command. .NET run configuration release no build tailspin space web. Now you should be able to see it in the browser. HTTPS. Was it 5,000? Low closed 5,000. HTTP localhost, darn it. HTTP localhost 5,000. Not secure. Continue, yes, that's working. You can interact with the page now, including the leaderboard. When you select the player's name, you see the details of the player. When you finish, return the terminal and select Ctrl-C to stop the application. Ctrl-C. Create a feature branch. In this section, you create a Git branch so you can work on files. Create a branch, Git checkout, copy. Git checkout branch feature home page text. Make changes, test it locally. So we go to index.ch, CSHTML. Where did they put the index? There. Views home directory. Views home, yes. Copy. What do we need to do here? Look for the text and example site for learning here. And we have to paste in the new text, replace the text with the previous step with the following mistyped text. There's a typo in there, apparently. Yes, official is not correct. Okay. Note that official is intentionally misspelled. We'll address that error later in this module. In your terminal, run .NET build, configuration release. I think we already have that one on stack. Oh. Build, configuration release. That's built. Now run it again. That should give us localhost 5001. There you are, with typo. Following instruction, there's a typo. Finished, you can return to the terminal window. Control C. Run git status. You notice the one file changed. Add the file. Git add tailspin spaceweb web views home index. And now put a comment in. Improve the text. That's what you call improve. Git push origin, copy. Not sure why it's saying the error, because even so it puts it in. Run this GitHub push. Is that what we did? Yeah. Go to GitHub. There. Go to GitHub, see what that your browser has been pushed to remote repository. Where can we see that? Go to GitHub to see that your branch was being pushed to your remote repository, your recently pushed branches. Must be this one, feature home page text. Yes. Four commits. Okay. Last commit 2 minutes ago. That's a change for the official space thingy. What's your Azure pipelines to build? Pipelines. Next. Improve the text, and it's already done. As you did previously, Azure pipelines automatically blah blah blah. Synchronize any changes to master. While you were busy working on your feature, there might have been changes to the remote branch. Before you create a pull request, it's common practice to get the latest from the remote master. Let's get into process now. Git checkout master. Git checkout master. Git pull origin master. Git Pool, Origin, Master. Ready up to date. Ready up to date. Git checkout feature home page text. Git checkout home feature. Feature home page text. Text. Git merge master. Git merge master. Already up to date. Yeah. Push your local branch again. Git push origin. When you incorporate changes from the remote repository into your local feature branch, you need to push your local branch back to the remote repository a second time. Although you didn't incorporate any change from the remote repository, let's practice the process to see what happens. Git push origin. Git push origin. Feature. Home page text. Still giving the HTTP request issue, but it still is working. Let's close VStudio and try again. Code dot. Let's see if there's connection here. Add C sharp extension. No problem. Back to the instructions. Let's try this again. What's the fatal HTTPS? HTTP request exception. I wonder what it is. Let's Google that. Must be related to GitHub. Visual Studio Code. It was asking me to log in, but still feels it's an error. That's exactly what we have. My understanding that GitHub has switched to TLS 1.2, causing the error when your program is still using TLS 1. First, you need to download the latest version of Git Windows Credential Manager. There. Microsoft. Download and install this. Why is it in here twice? It's step two, restart your machine. That's not what we're going to do. Let's do this after a call. Let's get back to the instructions for now. Submit a pull request. In this section here, submit a pull request you just did previously. Go to GitHub. Where's my GitHub thingy? Here. Go to your tailspin. So this one. In the drop down list, select your branch. This is Microsoft. I need my only one. My one. Where's mine? It's Microsoft. I need my own. There you go. Select the branch. Create a new pull request. Make sure the base is mine. Not the Microsoft repository. Title, improve the text at the top of your homepage. Description, receive the last homepage text. Step doesn't merge any code, tells others that they have changed, blah, blah, blah. Select create pull request. This again will take some time. We compare it to the project. See, it's now running. We need to wait for this. Follow this. Restore point, build project, publish the project, publish artifacts, check, check out, finalize the job, finished. Now it's finished here. Create pull request, as we did. Details, that's what we did. Select merge pull request. Merge pull request. Confirm merge. Select delete branch. Continue. Add a batch. It's important for members of the team to know the status of your build. An easy way to quickly determine the build status of is to add a build batch to your to the README file on GitHub. Let's check in on the team to see how it's done. Andy is at his desk sifting through the emails. He is answering the third email that's related to the status of the build game. There has to be some way to automatic status message. We have the pipeline, so we should be able to put some status somewhere. Maybe Mara knows how we can do that. And Andy finds Mara talking with Amita in the break room. Hey Amita, mind and borrow Mara for a second? I have to get to meeting anyway. Borrow anyway. Hi Andy, what's up? I really like the changes you've made to the build pipeline by using Azure Pipelines, and Git is a great version control system. I was wondering, is there a way to let people know the status of the latest build? Actually, we can build a build batch. What's a build batch? A build batch is part of my Azure Pipelines. That methods that you can use to add an SVG image that shows the status of the file of the build on your GitHub repository. Most GitHub repositories include a file name README, which is markdown file that includes essential details of the documentations about your project. GitHub renders this file on your project's homepage. Here's an example. For this exercise, you make your build batch visible to everyone. This might not be a good idea for your private projects, since your build information will be made available to the public. To make sure your build batch is visible, navigate project settings in the left pane of Microsoft Azure DevOps. You have to go to DevOps. Where is DevOps? There's DevOps. Where do we need to go? Project settings in the left of the pane of your Microsoft projects. Project settings, I think it's this. Yes. On the pipeline, select settings. Pipeline settings. There you go. Turn off, disable anonymous access to batches. Disable anonymous access to batches. No, you want that enabled. Disabled. You can do this for all projects in your organization if you wish, by turning off the same setting in the organization pipeline settings. Add the build batch. Up until now, you created Git batches locally to make the changes to the Git space game. You can also propose changes directly through GitHub. In this section, you do that to set up your status batch in Azure DevOps. In the left pane, select pipelines. That should be going here. Pipelines. Then select your pipeline. Select the dots, status batch. Under simple markdown, select the copy button. Under simple markdown, where's the simple markdown? Select the copy button to copy your markdown code to the clipboard. Where's that? Oh, here. Copy. In GitHub, go to your project. Where's my GitHub? Here, I think. Here's my project. Make sure you're on the master branch. I am. In the files area, open the README. Select the pencil icon to open the file in the editor. Make this a little bit wider. It's a little bit smaller. It's already done. Select the pencil. At the top of the page, add a blank line. And paste the contents of the clipboard. That's this. Select the preview changes. Here. Has your pipelines succeeded? Okay, select the preview changes tab to see the proposed changes. GitHub renders a markdown file and shows you the build batch. Commit your changes to master. In this section, you commit your changes to the master branch. Scroll to the bottom of the page and specify commit message. Add build batch. Leave the commit directly to master option. Yeah. And then select commit changes. Your batch is displayed on the README file. Simple as that. Nice. This process is more basic way to merge code into GitHub. Instead of committing directly, you can have created a pull request with your changes for others to review. In practice, you would switch to the master branch and pull the latest changes from GitHub the next time you need to add a feature or a bug. Mara, you just made a change directly to master. Why didn't you use the flow you taught me? You know, the feature branch. We could have done that, but sometimes when people are changing on only the README file or other documentation file, they commit to the master right then. Plus, you and I were able to verify the work together before we merged the change. But this change brings up a good point. If we all just commit to the master when we want to, we could be letting problems in the code slip into the master branch. I've been meaning to talk to you about that. And the Mara continues the conversation while walking back to their offices. Continue. Track your build history. An easy way to track the build, important events in your Azure DevOps project is to create a dashboard. A dashboard enables team members and observers to understand and track build trends at a glance. In this unit, you set up a dashboard and add widget to the track your build history. Andy puts together a report of the progress the team's making. He's in the middle of searching through all the build reports and build requests to try to get a big picture when Mara walks in. Hi Andy, I have a question on feature I'm working on. Do you have a minute? Sure, I could use a break. There has been an easier way to sum up the builds and see where there are patterns of failure. Actually, there is an easier way. We can set up a dashboard, so I can have a summary of the information I need in one place. I'm all ears. What's the dashboard? The dashboard is a customizable area in DevOps where you can add widgets and extensions to help visualize areas of your DevOps solution. For example, you can add a widget to show the history of the builds. Give a burndown view, show you the current pull request. Add a build history widget to your dashboard. In DevOps, select overview and then select dashboard. Where's my... Let's see where the... In here. Overview. dashboards. Select add widget. Let's make this one a little bit smaller. Add widget panes, search for build history. Build history. Drag the build history tile to the canvas. Select the gear icon. Where's the gear icon? Here, keep the build history title. In the pipeline drop down list, select pipeline. There you are. Keep all branches selected. Select save. There you go. Cool. Hover over each build to review the build number when the build was completed and the elapsed time. And done editing. 3 minutes ago. 49 seconds. Okay. Each build succeeded, so the bars on the widget are all green. If a build has failed, it would appear red. Select one of the bars to drill down into the build. There you go, then you jump to the build. To display more widgets, select extension gallery at the bottom of the add widget pane. Next, add a rule to require a review. In this unit, you set up a rule on GitHub that requires the reviewer to approve changes that can be merged into the master branch. As a bonus, you will fix the typing error on the Space Game website homepage. Currently, the team allows you to make changes and make pull requests to merge code into the branch because no review is required. It is possible for incorrect and unstable code to creep in. Andy decides that he wants to check to pull to the pull request the form of another pair of eyes. He wants to set up GitHub to require some other than the pull request author to review the code before it's merged. So let's see how it's done. Andy heads off to find Mara and spots her at the desk working away, her head bobbing to the music in her earbuds. Mara, I've been meaning to talk to you about something. Mara looks up. What can I help you? Several small mistakes, blah, blah, blah. And then I want to get some approval. Add a rule. In GitHub, go to your Space Game project repository. GitHub. Where's my GitHub? There. No, it's not GitHub. Select the settings tab near the top of the page. Let's go to this one. Settings. On the menu, select branches. Make sure the master is selected as your default branch. Yeah. Select add rule. Branch name pattern enter master. Select the require pull request reviews before merging. Require pull request reviews before merging. Required approved reviews value is 1. Create a rule in the master branch, select create. And then save changes.
Without you, then why don't I feel any better? Sticks and stones.
At the bottom of the file list of choice option named include administrators. This option is required requires repository admins for follow the rule. You don't set that because you're an administrator of your repository and there isn't another reviewer. In this unit, for learning purposes, you review and approve your own pull request. Submit a fix. So go to Studio Code. Git checkout master. Git checkout master. Git pull origin master. Git pull origin master. Git room. Oh, you see the two files updated, index and readme. Readme. Two files. That is the index, yeah. To fix the error, create and check out a branch. Git checkout. Git checkout B. Git checkout B. Bug fix. Home page typo. Home page typo. Yeah. Switch to bug fix home page typo. Open index CHTML. This one already have that. Make this official. Welcome to the official space game site. Yeah. Save this. Save the file in the terminal stage and commit the change. Oh. Keep doing this. Git status. Modified index. Add file. Git commit with typo fixing. Git push origin. Test the rule in GitHub. Look for the bug fix home page typo entry. There. Branch. Bug fix home page typo. There we are. One commit. Seven commits ahead, one commit behind. Looks master. Create a pull request, select compare and pull request. Oh. That's select compare and pull request. You recently pushed branches. There is the change. Compare a pull request. Where is that button? Compare a pull request. compare pull request. Select compare and pull request is two options. Compare. Base should be our own branch. Create pull request. Set your fork as a base. Create pull request. As you can see, the human review is required. Review required. Practice you would assign a team member, yes. In this unit for learning purposes, you merge your own pull request to merge pull request. Select merge pull request. Merge pull request. An admin. As an admin, you may still merge your pull request. Let's see, to merge pull request, select merge pull request. Select the use your administrative privileges to merge this pull request. Merge this. Yeah, just merge pull request. Select use your administrative privileges. Confirm merge. Delete the branch. Done. Next, clean up your Azure DevOps environment. You've done the task in the module. In this unit, you move the item to the done state on the Azure board. Move the work items to done. In practice, definition done often means that working software is in hands of your users. In this unit, for learning purposes, you mark this work as complete by yourself because you and the Tailspin team started an improved code workflow that uses Git and GitHub. At the end of each sprint of a work iteration, you and your team might hold a retrospective meeting in which you share the work you completed, what went well in the sprint, and what could be improved. In the Azure DevOps, select boards. I have to go to DevOps again, here, boards. There's the instruction, here, boards. Boards, it should be. Boards, there it is. And drag the create Git-based workflow, that's this one, to done. From doing to done, disable the pipeline and select your or delete your project. Each module in this learning provides a template that you can run to create a clean environment, so you don't need to keep it. That means we can just go to here, I think. And we have this old one. So where's the delete option? This is the previous one. Where's delete? This is disable the thing, delete project. Delete your Azure DevOps project that includes blah blah blah. In future models, you'll be able to run another one with new project. Choose this option if you don't need the DevOps project for future reference. To delete the project in Azure DevOps, you go to your project. We recommend that you name your project Web Workflow. Select the gear icon next to the project name. See? There's no gear icon. Here, maybe. Oh. Wow. It appears when you hover over nothing. How useful is that? Initiative ops, blah blah blah. Open the gear icon. In project details area, scroll to the bottom and then select delete. Let's check if it's the right one. Space game web. Pipeline, yes. You have to type it in. Let's make a copy of this. Delete. It's gone. Now this one. Also hidden thingy over there. Delete. Space game web workflow. Copy. Delete. There you go. Already a lot of other projects. Next summary. In this module, you learned how to collaborate with other people in GitHub, blah blah blah. Learn more, try GitHub Desktop. Learn more Git. Define your workflow, understand your GitHub. All more reading to do. Source control and migration strategies. Single branch import, Git DFS, all other options, implement branch strategies, feature branch workflow. The core idea behind a feature branch workflow is that all feature development takes place in a dedicated branch. That's all discussed previously. GitHub workflow defines a strict branching model. Forking branch workflow, that's also what we did. Use branch policies, that's what we did. Pull request strategies. Module incomplete. Go back to finish. Interesting. Really? Start all over again. Which type of version control enables you to work your own copy? That was the distributed. Git branch is used to copy only the part that you want to work on. Makes this without affecting. That's this one. The git pull command uploads changes from your. That's pull. This one. Downloads. Check your answers. Continue without saving. Sign in. Oh, I'm not signed in. Why? Really? That's what we all did. Oh, we have to do it again. Come on, distribute it. Make changes without affecting. Download. Yeah. Download the merges, check your answers. Congratulations, you all answered already. Complete. This is what we did. If you hit bang project in the chat room, then you can see the link to this this exercise. You can do it yourself. This is what we all did before. Push it to now. Push change through. That's what we did. Not sure why we were thrown out of the progress. Track your build history is what you did. Unlock achievement. Now the module is complete. Right. Print screen. We finished. Let's make a screenshot of this. Okay. Let's wrap that up. We already unlocked the achievement. So, close this and have a look at the thingy. So we now finished two of the four items. Let's bring this over from the other screen. We just finished this one. We first created the build pipeline as your pipelines, the previous one. And now implement code workflow in your build pipeline. That's the second one. 1 hour and 27 minutes. Let's check if that's actually true. That's 1 hour and 51 minutes that we needed to complete this. And we still have to run quality test the build pipeline and scan code for vulnerabilities. What's the time? 11 o'clock. So maybe a break, 15 minutes, and then I'll be back with the next entry. So I can get some more water. And wrapping up the video for YouTube that is getting a splitter. So let's all close this. This one can keep open. Close all of this. Close this. Close the command window. Explorer command window. And we can keep this open for now. Okay. Another module down from the build challenge. That means, let me fix that administration there. Azure DevOps, we now completed this one with a one with it, adding two and a checkbox. Overview, we're now 15 down and 28 total. There's 13. We still have to do 13, and I will do one in about 15 minutes from now. When I quickly disable the stream and then start again. So I'll be back. Just wrap this up and be back in about 15 minutes. Let's say, what's the time? It's now almost 11. Let's say 11:15. I will be back for the next run. So, I didn't show the screen. Let's quickly show the screen with the progress. This one I fixed. We finished this one. 2 out of 4 is done. Total 15 of 28 and 45% down. That's not quite accurate because we have been doing some large modules and there are some smaller ones left for the end of the week. So let's wrap this up. Thanks for watching for now, watching the implementing the workflow with the pipeline with Git and GitHub. So the next one will be run quality tests in your build pipeline and Azure pipelines. So thanks for watching and see you in about 20 minutes, 11:15. Bye-bye.